everybody, how's it going? So I got Jen's turbo loaded up, but I'm not going riding. We started talking, we first discussed getting a third unit for the kids to drive or friends to drive when we go places. Then upon further discussion, we decided to upgrade hers. So I'm on the way to a dealer in Ohio. Hers in for another unit. So it's going to be an upgrade. So is it going to be Turbo R, Pro R, Maverick R, just an X3? I don't know. We'll soon find out. So I'll let you know when we get there. All right, here we are. Bob's Cycle in Sydney, Ohio. So you can probably guess what brand I'm getting. It'll be another Polaris Razor. Let's go find out what model. All right, I'm back. Been back for a while. Had some things to do. For me, it was about a 7-hour round trip there and back. Bob's Cycles in Sydney, Ohio. Yeah, I'm back with the new unit. So now we have a 2020 Turbo S and a 2024 JL Ultimate. My motto is go big or go home, so we went big. Yeah, there it is. It's the matte, I think they call it matte heavy metal color. Sort of like a gray with some blue, with the blue accents. So yeah, here it is. I'm gonna try to do a like a little side-by-side comparison with the Turbo S. See the size difference. I'll probably do that hopefully tomorrow if it doesn't snow too much.
Back there, but got power, that's for sure. So take it for a little ride. got braking done.
The OG 2020 Turbo S and the new 2024
Pro R Ultimate. Nice unit. So let's see the Turbo S. Of course, it's a turbo, 168 horsepower compared to a 2-liter four cylinder naturally aspirated engine in the Pro R, 225 horsepower. Both have the dynamic shocks. Pro R has a different drive modes. Some of the differences that stick out right away are the box style A-arms in the Pro R, pretty beefy compared to just the tube style A-arms in the Turbo S. The width, I have the System 3 B-lock wheels on the Turbo S with the 32-inch Rockzillas. I'm sitting about 75 inches wide on this compared to the stock wheels and tires on the Pro R, which is about 74 inches. The height, I think the height difference is just because I have a aftermarket cage, 911 fab. Looking for a cage, hit up Tim, does awesome work. The stock cage on the Pro R isn't bad. I'm gonna keep it for a little bit, but it'll eventually be changed. Move around to the back. The Pro R is about, I'd say, a little over a foot longer than the Turbo S. I'm not sure how that'll help or hinder riding on the trails, so we'll see how that goes. Both have the high clearance radius rods. Pro R has a tow link that runs through the trailing arms. Turbo S does not. So yeah, there you go. Hopefully we'll be on a ride soon to compare them on the trails. That's what we mostly do is trail riding. So if you can think of something that I should do to the Pro R, let me know. They can make it better. I'm not sure how much better it can get, but let me know. So there you have it. If you watched the video, please subscribe. Help me out. I'm trying to build those subscribers. And we'll see you in the next one.